The Chicago Bears unusual pick, it's just absolutely blowing people away if you understand it. What's up, everyone, and what a draft we just had. GM Ryan Poles, he was determined to address every single hole in this roster with limited draft picks that we had, and in the fourth round, he filled one that most of us, we weren't even thinking about, and the fix needed in this case was actually at punter. And Poles filled it with Iowa punter ToryTaylor. Now, before you get all riled up thinking this was a silly pick, why didn't we address our real needs? We really used the highest pick on a punter in 5 years? I mean, drafting a punter isn't going to be super popular. But I'm telling you, this guy is just unique. And Kevin Fishbane, he said it best on Twitter. When do you take a punter in round 4? 1, when it's ToryTaylor. 2, when you struggled at punting the previous season. And 3, when the day 3 talent, it isn't what it used to be. So, okay. When in this situation, Poles, he wasn't just going to take a defensive end just for the sake of doing it. He's not one to be forced to do anything. And by the way, he then proceeded to trade with Buffalo over after this to grab Austin Booker at defensive end, who's just a steal and a guy profiled as a nice fit for us just a few days ago. So I like the pick much better because he pulled the trigger on a defensive end afterwards. Instead of this, he chose to do something smart. He found an unexpected weapon. Go get the guy who's the best by far in his position group, ToryTaylor. He's one of the best ever to punt the ball. How good? 116 punts inside the 20 since 2020. That's 37 more than the next best college football punter. What else? He has a reputation, rightfully so, of just having a monster leg, and he holds almost every desirable NCAA record. Best of all time marks, a 46-yard career average, 4,479 total punt yards set in 2023. I mean, that broke a record set in 1938. Might say something that Iowa's offense wasn't that good, but still, that's a huge record. Another question, do we have a huge need? Absolutely. Our punter, Trenton Gill, he had 38 net yards per punt last season. That ranks dead last in the league. An 11.9% touchback rate, tied for third worst. Wait, there's more. His 26.9% of punts inside the 20-yard line, that was fourth worst. This guy, on top of this, Taylor, he might be flat out the best to ever punt the ball. In 3 different seasons, he was named a first-team All-American, 2020, 2022, and 2023. And last year, he earned the unanimous honors and won the Ray Guy Award as the nation's top punter. And with 4 years of experience in the Midwest, Taylor has punted in all 4 seasons. That includes days with 50-mile-per-hour wind gusts, Purdue and Wisconsin, below zero wind chills in Minnesota, snow in Iowa. Sound like that might work in Chicago? He might be tailor-made for us. And it's not just distance. It's almost unheard of placement proficiency. Last year, Taylor, he placed 32 punts inside the 20-yard line and 23 inside the 13. That's on top of 40 punts of 50-plus yards. And in 2021 and 22, 77 of his 162 punts landed inside the 20. He also averaged 40 or more yards per punt in 43 career games, which is an NCAA record. I'm not crazy here. Do yourself a favor and look up a highlight reel on him, especially what he did last year, what he provided for the Iowa football team. I'll wait. I want to highlight some of his ridiculous performances, and this is provided by The Athletic. I don't need to tell you guys that The Athletic is an amazing source, so let me scroll down here. Let's look at these highlights. In a pair of top 10 showdowns in 2021, Taylor, he tipped the game in Iowa's direction against number 4 Penn State. 6 of his 9 punts landed inside the 20, including the 1, the 2, 2 times, the 3, the 8, twice, and the 12. At number 9 Iowa State, he averaged 51.1 yards on 8 punts, parking 5 inside the 20, 6, 9, 10, 13, and 20-yard line. I mean, think about what that outrageous field position does for an offense. In the 2022 season opener, Taylor averaged 47.9 yards on 10 punts with 7 punts inside the 20 to help beat eventual FCS. I can't talk. He put 7 punts inside the 20 to help beat eventual FCS champion South Dakota State, 7-3. 6 of his punts were down inside the 12-yard line, and 3 were 50 yards or longer. Iowa's defense, they scored 2 safeties on a pair of his punts that landed inside the 10-yard line. I mean, the defense took advantage of this and scored 2 safeties and won the game. I mean, this guy, he's just a weapon. Let's look at another one. Last year, Taylor averaged 50.6 yards on 10 punts in a 15-6 win at Windy, Wisconsin. 5 of his 10 punts went over 50 yards, including 2 beyond 60 yards, 60 and 62. 6 were down inside the 20-yard line. 0 of his punts were touchbacks. I mean, this guy provides a huge advantage from a fully unexpected place. I'm going to move this screen down. If you'll let me. There we go. I'm my own producer, so pardon me. I mean, friends, right? Field position is so important, and we've been losing it. Taylor isn't just a normal punter. He was basically Iowa's whole offense last year, and it's the first time I'm going to say this. That punter, he's a weapon. We upgraded an important position with the best player in the class, or perhaps ever. I'd like this less if we left the defensive end spot untouched, but as I shared, Poles, he handled that too. That's almost every issue shored up when starting out with only 4 picks. And the best part, we didn't mortgage the future. We have a full arsenal of picks next year with 3 picks in the first 2 rounds. And to get that 5th rounder from Buffalo, to get him to get our defensive end, we just gave them a 4th, and we'll likely have another 4th if the Justin Fields trade works in a way that he gets at least 51% of the snaps. So I'm pretty confident that he's going to win that starting job. We'll wait and see. This was just such an efficient and focused draft. GM Ryan Poles, he recently talked through the fact that this year's class was top-loaded and that the depth was poor outside the first couple of rounds compared to other years. And I'd argue that wide receiver is an exception to that. But next year is a different case, especially at defensive end, especially at linebacker. And there's no way anyone can look at this draft and say it wasn't fantastic. And to look at the body of work, what Poles has done during his time here is just so very good. I think we have a winner built right now. And I, for one, I'm done with the Bears PTSD stuff. It's a great time to be a Chicago Bears fan, and I just can't wait for OTAs to start. I'm going to start talking through some undrafted free agents that we're starting to sign. I still have this defensive end that we drafted to still profile, but if you look back a couple of days, I already profiled him as a great fit for our team. And you guys enjoy your day. Bear down. Love that you spend this time with me. And hey, it's going to be a great off season still. See ya.